In August 2020, Olympus launched their much-anticipated 100-400 dedicated telephoto zoom lens in the UK. Its maximum focal length of 400 millimeters is equivalent to 800 in 35 millimeter film. With a 2x teleconverter, this can be extended to 1600 millimeters. Whilst it is ideal for wildlife photography, my interest as a landscape photographer is its image stabilization for hand holding, coupled, of course, to the EM1 Mark II camera's stabilizer. Armed with the gear, I sauntered off to Addington Hills in the London borough of Croydon. There are good views of the capital that include Canary Wharf and the city. Now, for a comparison, this is the view taken with a standard lens at 25mm. That, of course, is 50 in film, before donning the new lens and teleconverter. The distant views have a touch of atmosphere that has affected sharpness a tad. I was also buffeted by a strong northerly wind. I give the main exposure details. I also spot metered, sometimes use shutter priority, sometimes program. Then I saved to RAW and digitally processed in Adobe Lightroom. Now, these are JPEG copies, much reduced in size for YouTube, so please keep that in mind. But first, a progression from 100mm to 400 on Canary Wharf. Now for a similar progression on the City of London. I was careful to use shutter speeds conducive to hand holding, the shortest being a 250th of a second. I did try a 60th, but it is not sharp, which may be due to the gale howling around me. Now for the teleconverter, and it's no nonsense, straight in at 800 millimeters. That, of course, is 1600 in film. The teleconverter does seriously restrict the maximum aperture at full telephoto to factor 13. Another eye-catching feature in the far distance, about 20 miles away, is Wembley Stadium. Ideal, again, for the teleconverter at 800 millimeters. Bearing in mind the possibility of atmospherics affecting clarity, I tried a couple of closer features and they appear to confirm my concern about atmospherics impairing the far distant views. If I am honest, this lens is not intended for landscapes, but I like to bend the rules and offer an alternative. I am sure that wildlife photographers will revel in its possibilities, and I have enjoyed my brief excursion with this 100-400 lens by being just a little different.